I'm here in Word for the Web, and this is free for anyone in a school account or a home or consumer account. I have my passage, and I'm going to go choose the Immersive Reader from the View menu here, and then I'll launch Immersive Reader. Here's the Immersive Reader, and I'm not going to do a full demo of it. There's a link in the upper right if you want to explore all the features of the Immersive Reader, but we'll be showing Reading Coach. So I'm going to go to the upper right for Reading Preferences, and you're going to see this new choice that says Reading Coach right here. And I'm going to turn this on. Now you'll notice when we turn the Reading Coach on, the play button at the bottom of the Immersive Reader changes to a microphone. And now it says Start Reading. So let's click this. I need to make sure that I've given microphone access. So if you haven't yet in your browser, you'll need to click Allow. Then you can read out loud for up to 10 minutes. And when you're done, you'll click that Stop button. And I'll click Start Reading, and I'm going to get a little bit of a countdown. There we go. The study of Earth's landforms is called physical geography. Landforms can be mountains and valleys. And I'm just going to speed up and read through the rest of the passage. Now I'm done and I click that stop button at the bottom. You'll see you get a reading report that pops up. It has accuracy rate, correct words per minute, the time spent reading, and words to practice. And this is great also for at home. Could be that you're a parent and you want to have your child practice reading. Say, hey, spend 5 minutes reading. What's also really nice is people can put whatever passage they want into the Immersive Reader. So whether you like Harry Potter or whether you like Rick Riordan or any other topic, you can practice reading out loud with that topic. Now, when I'm done, I also have practice words, and it says, hey, here are 5 words to practice. These are the words that were most mispronounced. So I will click practice words.
These words were the most challenging for you. Select any word to tackle them again.
So these were those 5 words that I mispronounced the most. The first one here, I can go click on geography.
When you're ready, press the microphone and read the word out loud.
So you get a little bit of coaching here. Now I can explore these different supports. So I can stretch the word into syllables. I can hear it read.
Geography.
I can also get a picture if one exists. So I have lots of different supports I can explore. So now when I'm ready to read the word, I'm going to go click the microphone at the bottom. Geography.
Your effort is showing. Great reading.
All right. So in the lower right, I can click the next word. Now we're going on to physical. And again, I can stretch the word. I can listen to it.
Physical.
All those different types of things. And I can step through. And if I mispronounce that word, let's see here. Physical.
Keep trying. You're almost there.
So I get a little bit of coaching and I can keep playing around. We'll go back to the home screen. So you get a little star for the word that you got right. I didn't quite get physical yet. I could keep practicing. There's also a settings gear in the upper right. If I click this, I can still go and change the pronunciation sensitivity, the voice, and the prompting style. So you can change the coach as you're going through Reading Coach. At the end of this video, I'll show how you can customize the Reading Coach before you start reading. And I'll click close. Now the other note is that Reading Coach is supported in 116 languages and locales. There's a link on the screen and it's in the description of this video, so you can have lots of different ways to practice reading, whether you're a non-native speaker or you're learning a different language. I'm going to click the back button to exit Reading Coach. So I'm back here in my reading report, and what I'm going to do is just click close, and now I'm done. I could read again, or I could just exit Immersive Reader, whatever I want to do. Now, if you want to customize the Reading Coach settings before you start reading, I mentioned this earlier, you go to the Reading Preferences, and I'll turn on Reading Coach again. And there's this edit button right here. If I click this, you see the customized Reading Coach settings. First, we have pronunciation sensitivity. I like to call this the picky dial. How picky would you like the software to be when it listens to you? There's a default. You can make it less sensitive. So maybe for earlier readers or someone who is a non-native speaker, you might make it less sensitive or less picky. Or if you want to have more advanced, you can make it more sensitive or really picky. But I'm just going to leave it as default. You can also choose a voice. So the default is Jenny, and you can listen to that.
The study of Earth's landforms is called...
I can drop this down, and I can choose lots of different other voices. So maybe I could choose Jacob.
The study of Earth's landforms is called physical.
So many options. We have younger voices and other types of voices. So I'm just going to go back and choose Jenny as my default. And you can also select a prompt style. And this means what type of feedback would you like from the coach? More supportive or more direct? And we'll leave it as more supportive. And I'll click save. So that lets you customize your coach. Currently, Reading Coach is part of Immersive Reader in Word for the web. It's in OneNote, it's in Teams assignments, Flip, and it's coming soon to Minecraft and many other of your favorite Microsoft 365 apps.